Spooky.
There's a lot of erosion in that tunnel. Could come down any minute. Watch your step.
He's in there, apparently.
You've reached the devil's house. Now look for the target.
Sounds appropriate if Volgin is going to show up.
You have arrived at your destination.
Seeing anyone? I don't really want to use these too much because I do feel as if it makes the game way too easy. Because it immediately gives away the location of every enemy on the map. Because you can see them so clearly. Although earlier on, when you first start the game, the night vision goggles don't show the enemies so clearly. You have to upgrade them before you can do that. So at this point of the game, I have upgraded them, so nowadays they show the enemies very clearly. Although there doesn't seem to be any here right now. I don't like the music or those ambient sounds. It's very, ominous. Get bad vibes from this place. Alright, so this place is completely empty. That's what they want us to think. This is some sort of ambush. I got a feeling this is going to end with a chase sequence. Gonna have to drive the Jeep off here? Whoa. Maybe. If I'm that desperate. Oh. So I'm gonna look, just in case I need to escape really quickly. Yeah, I got a feeling I'm going to have to jump off this. And I wouldn't be surprised if the guy I have to save gets burnt alive by Volgin. Okay, there's no doubt about it, this is going to trigger a cutscene when I go through the door. Who keeps saying that? Is it those guys back there? It's got to be a cutscene, right? Whoa, look at all this blood. This don't look good. This is actually pretty spooky. Whoa, what? You see that? Did you see that? That moved. This is reminding me of that Grey Fox hallway in MGS1. Oh, every MGS game has the moment where it goes kind of into a survival horror game. Oh my god, look at this shit. Warpants? Whoa, this is pretty, anyone want to say anything about this?
No sign of any guards. It's never good when things are too quiet. Be careful.
I've seen a bit of this cutscene in the trailer. He's got that earphones in his throat, right? Like Chico had them in his chest in Ground Zeroes. I'm guessing they were turning him into a skull. Or in the process of turning him into a skull. What?
Extraction arrived at motherbase.
Jesus Christ. Wow. This is pretty dark.
Shabani, your boy sent me.
Doesn't he take out a knife by here? From the trailer.
Signet Obanatod. No goy break here, bun.
With the rest of them.
Burn with the rest of them.
That line was from the trailers again. This is an actual boss fight. Yeah, I saw water over here. What about this? Am I safe here? Yeah, water, yeah. Oh! Alright, where's... Ah, I see. I got it. So, should I wait for him to go underneath it, or should I just shoot it immediately? There's another one. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to wait for him to spawn underneath it. Okay. Look at that. I'm gonna shoot you again, where is he? Come on. Can I fault on him? He's stunned. What? Oh, Mattis. I want him. I think Mantis is stopping him. Oh yeah, I don't think there's a way. Maybe you can't extract him. I think Mantis will always stop you. Oh, he's on fire again. Let's get out of here. Where's the chopper? Where's the chopper? Did it land? Should I jump? Pretty crazy. Yeah, we've established he will yeah. Which I don't have on me. What, is this fight still going on? What? I destroyed the two water towers, so what else can I do? Maybe shoot Mattis? He pops up every now and again. Should I change my controller port to 2? There's no... There doesn't seem to be any other water sources in the area. I mean, there's that little pool, but it didn't seem as if that was doing much. Oh wait, is the chopper landing over there? Tunnel's destroyed.
Find a way to stop him and exfil my chopper. Anytime you need advice, just give me a call.
Oh, okay. We lure him over here. I'm sure there's one or two others in the area. Yeah. Is the chopper gonna land now? I'm thinking you can't fault on Volgin. Mantis, I think Mantis will just stop you every time, so I'm just gonna try and get out of here when I get a chance. So where's the chopper? Am I supposed to call it? Oh, okay, I see. I got it. Oh, yeah. There's another one over here. Come on. I'm in the clear. That was awesome. That was... Oh, yeah. I thought... That was just quiet. I thought it was someone jumping up then. That was great. That was a really fun set piece. I like that. I do kind of see what people say when they mean when they say there's no proper boss fights. Because that was a boss fight, I guess. But I kind of miss the health bars coming up in the corner of the screen. B, come on. I think I deserve an A for that. I think I did that quite well.
Skullface. So he was in Africa after all. Working behind the scenes. Even that man on fire at his beck and call. But what the hell was going on at the devil's house?
They're still trying to pretend as if it's not Volgin.
Throats, tapes playing voices. And those lumps on their chests. They look like the ones on the bodies at the oil field. The man on fire burned everything to the ground. But we were recording audio the whole time you were there. We'll conduct a thorough analysis of it.
That was fun. I really liked that. Honestly, I wish they dragged it out longer than they did. Because I guess that's what people mean when they say there's no proper boss fights. Because that little encounter with Volgin, that was over within a minute or two. I would have it took me about 4 minutes, but that's because I was messing around trying to fault on him, and I didn't realize I had to call the chopper. But most players would probably do that in about a minute or 2 minutes. You can just shoot a water tower onto him, and it's over. So I do. It was a great set piece, but I do wish they dragged it out longer. So I like boss fights. I always love a good boss fight, so I'm kind of disappointed that it was over so quickly. So I do wish they dragged it out a bit longer. But that was still a really fun sequence. That was great. That was a cool ass sequence.
Boss, word has it that a Western arms dealer is going to be inspecting a CFA outpost. It appears he's involved with nuclear weapons development in the area. My hunch is that this guy is somehow connected to Cypher. I've got no proof, but we know Skullface is working through PFs in the region. Anyway, it just so happens a job connected to this inspection has come in.
Please select.
Take a look at your iDroid.
I gotta say, the whole sequence where you first enter the factory and you're seeing all that blood and all of those bodies and the bloody, like, the curtains with all the blood on it and you're kind of pushing through them, that was pretty spooky as well. It just goes back, it's just reminding me about Silent Hills. It's bringing back painful memories, to be honest. It's just, what could have been? But of course, Konami pulled the plug on Silent Hills. It's just bringing. It's just such a shame. But that's another thing. I kind of wish they dragged out that little factory sequence a bit longer than they did as well. That was essentially two corridors, and then the cutscene played, and it triggered the boss fight. So that was a great little spooky sequence. So I kind of wish they dragged it out for a bit longer. Updated. Still a great sequence. I want more of it. That's what I'm saying.
Boss, about those invalids you saw in that devil's house.
Poor bastards. All strapped down to the beds, with those lumps on their chest.
The medical staff tell me they were probably a type of cyst.
Cysts can get that big.
In some cases, yes. But supposing they're a kind of atheroma forming on the surface of the skin, the size is just too big, and the appearance is all wrong. In the end, the medical team were at a loss. Those lumps were like nothing they'd ever seen. The fluid you said you got on your prosthesis when you touched one was burned off in the fighting, and the factory burned down too. None of the tests we did once you were back at the base revealed a pathogen that could have caused them. Meaning we don't have a single sample to work with.
Everything went up in flames.
What worries the medical team most is whether it's contagious.
whether there's a chance we could end up like that. And Motherbase's sanitation control has always been strict. After all, war is great at transporting diseases. For the time being, at least, there's no sign of contagion or any symptoms that could be related. One more thing. About the surgery that had been performed on the people in the Devil's House.
Yeah?
You said that their throats were cut open, with an acoustic tube pushed inside?
Right. The tubes were hooked up to tape recorders.
I bet the tapes are playing their voices.
Well, we picked up audio through your radio transmissions and recorded it here. The intel team has been working on analyzing
the tapes are recording and playing their voices.
What have they found?
There's nothing tying the contents together. We've got a report on 3 deaths in a car accident on the autoroute near Marseille. Protests outside the Libyan embassy in London. A press conference with the former Prime Minister of Sweden. A 4-month-old weather forecast for Balikpapan, and then commercials for appliances, cough syrup, and TV dinners. Assuming they're not all staged, they come off as recordings of your average public broadcasts.
Public broadcasts? Just radio and TV signals?
Yes, and from all over the world. We're looking into whether they're genuine or not, just to be sure.
In the trailer, what else? I think Skullface, yeah. In the trailer, Skullface talks about language and people chatting about there's some too deep for me kind of dialogue about language, you know, how about it brings people together and stuff like that. So I'm guessing this is somehow part of his master plan with, the deal with languages, whatever he was talking about in the trailer.
Suggestions, ideological common points, but I don't think it's going to get us anywhere.
Where were the recordings made?
There's nothing linking them from that angle either. Just like you reported, we've detected virtually every major language there is. French, German, Italian, Spanish, including South American accents. Then there's Russian, Hindi, Arabic, Portuguese, Mandarin, Cantonese, Japanese.
They're nothing if not thorough.
Well, I don't know if we've got them all covered. Ignoring the ones that have gone extinct, supposedly over 5,000 languages exist today. Besides, English isn't one of the ones we picked up.
Really? English?
I know. Only 5% of the world's population is a native English speaker. But when you factor in those who've acquired it as a second language, nearly 1/3 of the people speak it. The world's dominant lingua franca. You gotta figure they had it somewhere among all the languages in that place.
No English.
Bear in mind, we didn't hear everything that was played in that room. We couldn't isolate the more distant sounds due to static and the program could have been set to change every day. In a nutshell, for reasons unknown, people in that room with a common medical condition were made to listen to recordings in languages from around the world. It's not clear how the growths on their chests fit into it. It could have been treatment for them, or maybe an experiment of some kind.
I'm guessing one person knows.
Yeah, Skullface. He was there. The only thing we can say for sure is that he's involved.
Okay, let's move straight on to the next mission.
Expansion complete.
New platform? Oh, a new scope. Better start developing that.
Please specify.
What's the upgrade going to be? I don't see how my scope can be upgraded anymore. Like, what new features can they add? Rocket arm? Yeah, you just have to. Max. Oh, okay, so it increases the max rank I can analyze. Fair enough. Yeah, that's really all I'm interested in.
Please select a mission.
Okay, let's do it.
Please
next mission.
Select a mission.
21 the war economy. Eliminate some official at the airport. Okay.
Mission accepted. Heading to Central Africa. Deploying.
And this time around, I'm not going to look at the credits. I'm not going to look at the credits from this point onwards, ever. That would have been a really cool surprise when Volgin and Skullface popped up.
Eliminate
the so I'm just going to close my eyes for this bit.
In charge of supplying weapons to UNITA. The target stays at Nova Braga Airport. Head to the airport first.
Okay, I think the credits are... Yeah, they're done with the characters. So I'm eliminating. It's just going to be an assassination mission, unless it evolves into a surprise boss fight like the previous one did. I'm assuming we're going to fight Volgin and Mantis again at some point, because I hope we get a fight with Mantis, which is just Mantis on his own. Because Mantis was floating around with Volgin there, because he's obviously influencing or controlling Volgin. I think that's pretty obvious at this point. But I do hope we get the fight Mantis just up by himself, though. So I hope we get a boss fight completely dedicated to him on his own. And I hope he has some cool tricks, because every single Mantis boss fight in the series has had some really cool puzzle for you to solve.
They're holding some of our staff hostage. If we don't do something, they'll try to take off with our men. That would mean losing some of our finest manpower. Boss, take back that platform.
What?
This is a race against time. For all of us. Get on this mission right away, boss.
Okay. Yeah?
Please select a mission.
Okay, sure.
Mission accepted. Heading to
motherbase. Yeah, okay. I wasn't expecting this. By the way, this isn't as if it's some other player online infiltrating the base, because of course you can do that in FOBs, but I don't think online is ready at this point. So I'm assuming this is just the AI. This is just the game itself. It's not as if some other player online is infiltrating my base. Yeah, see, this is a main story mission. Okay, so this was scripted, I'm assuming. This sounds like it'll be fun. I think I'm gonna go nuclear for this.
Infiltrate the platform under enemy control and eliminate.
It might be a surprise. I'm just gonna close my eyes while the characters are popping up.
We'll move in and suppress the rest. The enemy have taken some of our staff hostage and are threatening to kill them if they're attacked.
Mosquito?
What? Support from us this time. Anything we do might be seen as an attack.
I'm not looking in the corner in case that's a spoiler.
Forgive me.
That's all the characters.
An enemy force in right under my nose. But one thing's for sure, they're gonna pay for it. Make certain of that, boss.
Man, this sounds like it'll be a fun mission. Looking forward to this. Eliminate the commander. Take off the suppressors, no point in them. Oh wait, can you be stealthy about this? Maybe you can. I doubt it. Maybe I should use this. No? It seems as if I can be stealthy about this. They've entered an alert status. So they're just searching at this point. Oh wait, this isn't the platform. Okay.
Analysis complete.
Is he an enemy? Yeah. Oh, okay. Ah, okay. Oh, shit. So you can be stealthy about this. Sweet. I will be stealthy, but if I get spotted, I'm not going to restart from a checkpoint like I usually do. I'm just going to go full lethal. If I do get spotted.
What's going on?
Come on, just...
Speak. Where are your friends?
I'm not gonna grab a specialist. These so-called specialists are just... not worth taking from my experience.
Analysis complete.
It's got an A in base development. So that's kind of weird as well, isn't it? I'm photoning him, and I'm already on Mother Base, so is... What sense does that make, exactly? There's a guy down there.
He's coming too. Roger that.
So, oh, he spotted the body.
You all right? Don't do it. Where are your friends? Spit it out.
I'll tell you what, doing the target practice spec up, side up on the R&D platform, whoa. It was hard. It made me very angry as well. Several times I fell to my death while doing that target practice. I'm sure those of you who have played the game and have attempted it, I'm certain you can sympathize with me. That was pretty tough, that side up. Oh, shut up, I don't want to know about your specialists. Can I free these prisoners? I would imagine so. Sup? I missed! What? Screw it. Actually, haven't really been developing any lethal weapons. I basically every single time I want to kill someone, I've basically either been using the rocket launcher for the vehicles, or I've just been using the assault rifle that they start you off with. I haven't even upgraded this once, and I am in trouble. Oh, can't quite get that guy. I gotta say, I do like the gore effects as well. When you shoot people in the face, I like the way the body reacts and the blood spray. Looks pretty authentic. Although I will say the best... Well, for when you shoot people in the body and the way their body reacts, the best game I've ever played, which has the most realistic movements, is Red Dead Redemption. I don't even like Red Dead Redemption, but I do like the way people react when you shoot them. Feels very authentic. It's easily the best, the most realistic looking reactions I've seen in a game. Although the reactions in this game are actually pretty, they seem pretty authentic. These guys aren't so tough. None of them are wearing helmets or anything, or any body armor whatsoever. Ah. Is that the leader up there? Oh,
boss, that's a serious injury. It won't heal on its own. It may be treated with first aid.
Fuck that guy. Someone got a rifle? I think someone's shooting me with a shotgun or something. Or it might have been the guy I just killed. I don't know. Oh, chill out. Yeah, can I use the shower? No, didn't think so. I actually know the layout of this platform quite well because I tried because of the spec ops mission. I did eventually do it. It took me like 25 attempts though. Worst thing is you have to climb to the top of this in order to start the side ops, and it takes a while to climb to the top. So every single time you fail, you have to climb all the way back to the top. Because the odds are you're very likely to be at the bottom of the platform when you fail it. Oh no. Yeah. Okay, so this leads to the top. Oh, well, we've got a helipad with this, so obviously. Anyone worth photoning at this point? Who's shooting at me? Oh, I was certain there was someone right next to me. I guess they just have really powerful weapons. Are you worth photoning? Yes, I'm taking you. Anyone else? Oh, he's got an A, but I'm going to kill him anyway. A plus. Oh, okay, I'm taking all three of them. As if I don't get killed in the process. Get down, get down, get down. Okay, so I think I hit the leader with the trank, so he should be falling down anytime now. Oh, there's more. Is he worth taking? No. If I wanted to lethal, just go lethal on these guys, this would be over already. But I would really like to fault on this guy. I'm certain I made a hit. Definitely hit him. Throwing a grenade as well. Okay, looks like there's one more guy. Oh, there's two. Nah, I'm not taking you. Still more people. Oh, there's someone down there. Do I only have to capture the leader, though? I think as soon as I capture the leader, it's all over. I guess everyone else will just surrender as soon as I do it. Who else is shooting at me? Where's the leader anyway? Should extract him last. Okay, now I can grab him. That's more like it. I guess that's it.
He's coming too. Roger that. You're going to extract him. Good thinking. We'll make him squeal till he's paid his due.
Hell yeah. What now? Do I... Yeah, surrender.
Escape is impossible. Lay down your weapons immediately. Surrender now. You will not be fired upon.
As you can see, that strut is a maze of ladders and pipes you can climb up and walkways. And the targets are placed all around there. So when you're doing that side ops where you have to shoot all the targets within a time limit, it's really tricky.
Extraction arrived at motherbase.
Level down?
Development project has been added.
Mission complete, boss.
Oh, it doesn't even give you a rank for this mission either.
Boss, we figured out who that enemy commander was. He was on the staff at motherbase 9 years back. Despite surviving the attack, he broke off from us and spent his years terrified that a cleanup squad would come after him. The isolation screwed with his sense of loyalty. A rumor, source unknown, had him convinced that the attack 9 years ago was orchestrated by you yourself. The big boss sold out his comrades to hide from the world.
The man who sold the world.
He thought that's why you weren't at the base that day. He was so desperate to take us down, he built up his own PF, copying us in every way. His idea of the perfect revenge. But in the end, he was just a victim of disinformation. I'll leave you to decide how to deal with him.
I think I'll... Are they actually gonna let me decide here? Security team. Oh, okay, so FOBs have been introduced. Although I'm recording this, I think, on the September the 3rd? Yeah, 3rd. So, I'm not sure if the online is ready yet. Because yesterday the online capabilities were disabled because they were updating them or something like that.
What I have in mind is to create a security team that can defend each of the platforms. Can I go ahead with that? So from now on, give some thought to building up the security team as well. One other thing. To devote some
is this going to be a whole entire different department?
To forward operating base. The more bases we have, the more staff we can house and the more materials we can secure.
Cannot be utilized in offline mode. Connect online. So can I do that right now? Yeah, undergoing maintenance, okay. I'm not that too concerned about FOBs anyway. I know a lot of people, when they heard about FOBs, they went apeshit and they're so hyped for it. Personally, I'm not really an online kind of guy. I prefer to just experience single player. I'm not often interested in multiplayer aspects of games.
Please select a mission.
Don't get me wrong, I will try out this whole FOB thing at some point. But I'm not devastated that the servers are offline at the moment. Yeah, that was fun though. That was a nice change of pace. That was fun. So, next one? Well, yeah, let's resume this one. Oh, I'm covered in blood. I can't be bothered to go back to Mother Base to wash it off. I did spot a camera on the way down from the helicopter, just in case you're wondering how this has already been marked. And there's a D-Walker as well. Although, it's not marking him for some reason. I guess it's because he's too far away, maybe. Where's he gone? Oh wait, now it's okay. It's been marked, it's all good. Oh, great.
Enemy presence detected. The map.
Those search lights. Oh, those search towers. I hate them.
You have arrived.
Great, you made it.
What's that?
I've sent the information to your map screen.
I think it's a shadow of a boot.
Target's predicted location. Check all around the target and plan carefully before moving in.
The map has been updated.
Someone's driving.
Boss, mission we've just received word that the arms dealer due to inspect Nova Braga Airport is on his way. Once his chopper has arrived, they'll be touring the facilities along with the target. Let him bring the target out into your line of fire.
So, you're saying I should wait? And this is the first time security cameras have ever popped up in the game as well. There were a few in Ground Zeroes. But this is the first time it's popped up in the Phantom Pain. The first ever security camera.
The chopper will be arriving any minute.
Analysis complete.
Follow the arms dealer, locate the CFA official. So is he landing in the chopper? Have I got this right?
There's a chopper landing.
Yeah.
It must be carrying the arms dealer. Keep your eyes on him.
That chopper? Oh shit. Better go over there ASAP. Although the game seems to be pretty lenient with these tailing missions. Because as I found out earlier, I was running after the Jeep and the guy got pretty far away. But it never gave me a mission failed. And it's a guy in a business suit. It's the first time we've ever come across an NPC like that. I mean, Skullface is kind of wearing a suit, but he's kind of the big baddie, so you would expect that. Is he wearing the helmet? Reflex mode is coming up. Oh. All of my rage. He is wearing a helmet. Ugh. You know, someone who data mined the game found snowy textures, that they did have snowy textures, but apparently this snow is never used anywhere in the whole entire game, so that goes to further enforce the idea that the game was unfinished.
Boss, get down. The enemy sniper. Stay low and crawl along the ground. That should enable you to sneak past enemies.
Is that really gonna save me from the sniper? Can I just... So he's in the building. Oh, it looks like I can go inside there. Huh. So that's one of few interiors. I have said it before, but I'll say it again. That's one thing I really miss about the Phantom... Well, about MGS. Is the interior locations, the government complexes. And the far majority of the Phantom pain, it's just... It takes place outside. And there's barely any buildings you can go inside. So that's one thing I'm kind of... I miss about Metal Gear. I doubt it. I wonder if I can fault on that. I'm not even going to bother trying. I'm pretty certain I can't. The sniper is kind of looking... I think it may be safe for me to crouch, at least. There's some guys around here with a decent rank, but I don't really want to fault on them because I'm pretty sure I will trigger an alert phase if I attempt to. Where's he walking to? It looks like he's outside.
Has the arms dealer made contact with the target? Can you see the target anywhere near the dealer?
I'm guessing he has now, since why else would Miller suddenly say that? I guess I should get over there ASAP. Is that him?
Is that him? Take a good look at their faces so we can ID them.
Kind of tricky to see from here. Oh, okay, apparently it is. Oh man, look at those crates. I so badly want to fault on them. Get some more hard metal, is it? I think that's metal. I just know, no. I really want to, but it's not a good idea. If the target saw me. Wait a minute. Is that the target? Yeah, okay. So I could end the mission right now if I kill this guy. Well, providing I'm able to escape the area after killing him. But per usual, Volgin in him would be a good idea. Oh no, we don't want this. No, that wouldn't work. I had an idea if I was thinking I could Volgin the truck. But it's in this hangar right now. That would be a really cool way to end the mission though. Oh no, this guy's driving it. shit. What if I climb in the back? Oh, what? Really? Oh, that would have been great if we were driving along. Could have just shot him in the back of the head. That would be pretty cool. Straight out of a movie. I started to feel really badass and sneaky going into the back of that truck. But I guess tranking the guy was a blunder I shouldn't have made. The mission is about to all go to hell. This asshole running away. Just gonna hold out in this room. D-Walker's about to spot me. Okay, I want both of you, but... I want all three of you, but I'm too lazy to carry every single one of them out. I guess I'll just grab this guy. I don't want to drag every single body out of this building. It's just going to take way too long. Oh wait, there's a camera. And the helicopter may notice. The photons can't actually hit the helicopters. We've all seen that in the E3 demo, so I better make sure that's passed over. Okay, I'm sure it's safe. So now I just gotta escape the zone. What's the fastest way to get out of here?
Good. You completed the objective. Now get out of there.
I could use the vents, but that's not really leading outside. What happened to the guy back here? What's he doing? Is he fake? No? Okay. Oh, you got a good combat. And since you are already outside, I think I'll take you. No, don't climb. Oh, too lazy to climb back. Yeah, I'm... whatever. Is there a hole in the wall, I'm hoping? I really don't want to backtrack all the way I came. There has to be a few other exits for you to take. Is that a gate there? I can see the fence, but... ooh, music. Can I hear music? It's getting louder. Really bug me. I must have passed it. It must be a bit back. Didn't turn out so well. I do think I should stop being so scared of using lethal weapons as well. Ideally, I would rather try and stick with tranquilizers, but if I need to, I should just go lethal. Just have some fun, you know. Yeah, I know there's a lot of people out there that get really anal if you decide to use lethal weapons. It's just like, whatever, people can do what they want. I did not see this door. Hey, so just escape the hot zone. Oh, it's kind of big. How about if we call a helicopter?
Please select a support helicopter.
I might as well just. I might as well have just left the area there. That was kind of pointless. I really wish I had my horse right now. And that's that mission.
No sign of the enemy. Mission complete, boss.
I really wish I was in the back of that truck. I wish I didn't shrank that guy. Otherwise, the truck would have just left the base and I could have just headshotted him a few miles away.
Mission complete.
And that would have been pretty cool.